Okay, so today, after I make sure I have a baseline of a functional application, I am looking towards changing component data. Okay, it works. Much like how I did with resources, where it's all dynamic, you can add importers and the component resource managers pools can be added dynamically, read dynamically, and basically, the idea is you can do a lot more things at runtime rather than having it all compiled in. I mean, you can, but you don't have to. The eventual idea is to make, yes, you'll probably have a bunch of items that will be statically compiled in and linked, the base core simulation, but that you'll be able to add mods, basically, modifications in extra linked in at runtime binaries. Anyways, I've done it for resource. What I need to do is that I need to do the same thing for component data, like the entity data itself. So the first part I need to do is like, so each of these, the position, camera, render state, render state, rigid body, these will be changed to be added in dynamically, much like resources already are here. First thing I need to do, but there's still a very specific item which is static, hard-coded in, and that's the ID and the entity name, the I the sorry the editor name. So that's what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to take this out of here, leaving all the dynamic stuff here, and I need to upload this to the calling context, which I think is this. Yes, let's get rid of this extra thing there. Okay, got entity. That's the node. Change that out. It's that. That's correct as well. I need to change it. Since I'm going to have the entity here, I need to pass it in instead of this M group thing. And I don't need to pass that in anymore. And change this to a Boolean return. There we go. Okay, we got that out. It's moved. Let's make sure that this works. It's already a split persistent the data A. So this should just basically work the same as before. Yes, this needs to be changed. So auto found. No, parsed. We'll throw in a little log for an error, although this case should really never occur. Failed to parse entity that. If that fails, it goes to exception. If that fails an exception, that's not failing. Even though realistically it should. Okay, well, whatever. Camera F5, make sure it runs as expected. Come on. Physics collision issue. Again later. along with the visibility issue. Come on. Okay, so this part at least is good. So it's these three items. Of entity data. This is because of component data is being shifted. Towards dynamic. These items main portion of the how importer. Okay. Okay. With that, and we had a to-do for fixing the collision is more to do with resource rework. I need to refine and fix up the threading of it. Okay, so next, for this, this isn't the main reason why I'm not taking things, why these aren't being moved to faux IMEX, it's because of the hard-coded nature of the entity, read and write, still, most, especially the read, really. So, what I need is, as part of this, these are resource important create functions. What I need is one map for key. Then I need a component import function. How is this specified? Bool star entity ID. And what would we need for entity ID? Not really. No, yes, we would. Because I need to pass it in so it can find the component pool and throw that in. It needs to know, yeah. Okay, YAML node. Takes in that. Yeah, okay. So these are the functions I need to add, import or remove, need the ability to add and remove it. It's m component functions. Yes, equals that. Oh, wrong one. That one. That one. Okay. So we go here. This is all for okay. Say position 3D like that. It'll be that key. It'll take in a function which I don't have yet. I'll define it here. It'll basically be this. Move it over. It's very similar to that, but not quite. Sorry, it's YAML. That's actually something I need to do now, is I'll need the position, all the pools need to have a common base that I can work with. Okay, just pause that for a moment. This had a vector of that. We're going to need a vector of okay, we'll put it into IMX for the moment. That's all I can really think of. Because it has to be. Does it have to be? I mean, technically it doesn't, but I'll put it here anyways. Because I need it for physics as well. So we'll say. That. So along the lines of foe resource pool base, do I actually need to? I don't like it. I really don't like it. Okay, moving on up to armature. No, not armature position. Come on, where is it? Wait a second. This is all the way up here, isn't it? No. No, 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 no. I have it somewhere else, don't I? Here it is. Oh, okay, yes. 3D pool. This becomes public of that and public of this. So public this needs to now also include here. So GLM. Really? That's. I would need EFG. Yeah, so FO is needed. So FO IMX. This visibility nonsense. Okay, to do fix visibility. Compilation. As I know, there's got to be a better way than this for visibility in this slow compilation. That's being born from it. I'm just not quite sure what yet. Okay, so back. Now we need to go into state data, state pools. Okay, simulation set, right? This is with vector, yeah. Okay, so we kind of do the same thing here. Vector of component pool. Whoops, yes, that. Component pools, wonderful. Don't need state systems quite yet. Obviously, I need a new laptop for this. There really aren't that many good laptops, though. Okay, so that at least, that's it seems to be pretty okay with that. So let's steer ourselves back into the function registrar for the moment. Can we do this? We're in. That's great. Now we're going to go through and do this. If we find this node, see, that's actually something I'm kind of, why did I have the keys? Because I wanted to prevent issues where there are multiple different items trying to reprocess the same node. That's not something we want to have happen. That's why I have the key. Yeah. Okay. Stop that. We do this. Let's return false. Got that. We'll have that. And a removal. Doesn't like that. Hmm. this is all this stuff down here. T-state pool's not. Right. So I need to go through. State pools, it's this type, so this is what I'm looking for. False. Obviously, Clang has decided to break again, so we've got to go through for auto const and iterator of the pools. Okay, let's reopen quickly to get the freaking server back alive. This is where we're going to operate. We're going to operate on this. Not quite what I was looking for. This is the YAML. Okay. So we got that in. Hopefully that goes in. That means when I go back to this, not the YAML generator, but we're actually doing the processing here. These are okay, so imagine much like a resource definition where we go through and say, hey, go through the subnodes. If go through the functions rather than we're going through the nodes. And come over to functions, okay. If I need to do this, so we found something, we found a subnode which is going to take this in, which is fine and all right. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, hey, auto, subnode, auto. I would just go into the other node, wouldn't I? So it'd just be like iterator dot second, and then I pass in the node. So the raw node, not the subnode even, just the node I'm currently on, entity. I need to pass in that, just like p state pools. Okay. Ooh, I don't actually. This is the thing that requires a number of changes all the way up the inheritance tree. Okay, and then going back down to the down here, component pools, that's what I'll pass in to here. Preferably that's what's going to happen. Boolean dynamic equals false. Actually, what I want to do is just, I want to do that, then I'll do this. So realistically, what I should be doing, if I remove this, The data should still come through, correct? Let's hope. Got a problem. Import state, what's going on here? I'm not passing in the component pools now. So P simulation set component. And I need to do the same thing here. Build a single job at a time, so it's group data probably. Right. The test stuff. Since I've updated it, I need to update this. It doesn't even matter. Okay. Please give me a position. Nice. All three items have a position. If I go to component pools, that are not quite. Let's go to P state pools. Position. The data pool to insert, we should have three items, correct? Okay. 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 Nice. That's okay. Camera is another one, and rigid body are also pools. These other two are not converted yet, so I can't quite yet, but I can get these other ones. So what I'm going to do first is going to put the commit the infrastructure, then I'm going to do the conversions separate. So I've got the, let's close all this up. It's a nice piece of music. Import a base, yes. That's not happening quite yet. I need to a little bit of Yeah. So got that table generator, which is the items for that. This hasn't been changed yet. This actually has been changed. That hasn't been changed yet. Not changed yet. This has been changed, yes. I need to change a portion of this. That, I okay, already did that. Headed. Groundwork for. Dynamically work with. Components. Base class and so with that part next, we do. Let's do the physics one. Would this be for IMAX? Yeah, because I need the base class. Oh. C++'s inheritance is really wearing thin on my mind. Or heavy on my mind, but my patience is growing thin. I need a different way. I can't use C++'s inheritance pattern or mechanism. It's just growing too unwieldy. I'm going to have to switch to something more C-like to remain sane. Such as like how Vulkan does their structs, I imagine, whereas like a struct type or something like that. Like I mean, it's still going to use C++. It's just not going to use the inheritance mechanism for the dynamic casting and that. It's just not going to happen. Not going to work. Not going to happen. Anyways, here. So that'll go through like that, which we go to the simulation set. We're going to add that. got the rigid body. We move up to here. We're going to have a function for importing this. As painful as it is. Have a look what it looks like here. It's a rigid body. Change the more generic And of course, the reason why all these things are here is because I can't move this stuff, like these, up yet. Dang, it's a catch, like physics, rigid, body, pool.hpp. Moving back down. Let's see if I can change that up. Really, is that not real? There we go. There's an error. Faux physics. What is it? Faux physics component. YAML rigid body, something or other that requires this one. Okay, I need these because of that for the moment, for the writing. Which is a whole, another can of worms I haven't even really touched on. Oh, I need the translator. That's something I actually do need for this as well. I forgot about that. So, moving back to the importer and stuff. Would it be here? No, it would just be part of this part here. See, this would not even have. There it is. Okay, we're still missing this. Or what? Second argument would lose const qualifier. I mean, I guess, yeah, that's true. We don't want to do that. So go to libs, include component that. Also means that we want to change it here, right? So we have, no, it is already const. That's why I'm having problems. Okay, so let's see. This is rigid body, so it should fall down. Nope, it did not. Wah wah. Okay, why? Oh, I didn't add it. I did not add it. Whew, that's a good thing. Well, it's not so good, but it's a good thing that there's not an actual problem yet. There it goes. Okay. So before we go further, we need to fix up one thing. Was it this one? No, it would have been here. Adding group translator. Don't need it here. Yeah, so that's a fix up there. Rest of this. So I just need one more to go, which is camera. Camera. There we go. So go find the camera pool, which is this. Got that, adding it to the simulation set, so it's... Which one is it? Is it the first, second, or what? What's the order? Camera's second. Okay, similar thing here. Adding a camera version. So we got that camera. Doesn't require a group translator. So we just clear that out. This is one that uses a random location in memory. Okay, I'm on. Okay, seems to be fine so far. So that's these three. Camera. No longer hard-coded importation through. Okay, so that's that. Now I need to convert the remaining two, which is render state and armature state, which are still currently using maps. So I need to convert them to using the component pool and then convert that to be dynamically loaded. So let me grab a quick drink and then I'll get on that next. Okay. Well, actually, that's the thing I should do right there. Heard your body, change that up, fix that up. So. Wait, hold on. Fix up. Now I'm pretty sure I'm probably added application, which I didn't want to do. Undo the last commit. I probably have like application. Yeah, this one should not be part of that. Come on, think about it. There we go. Lovely. So first one I'm going to work on is armature state. That's probably the one with the least amount of entanglements. That's as loud as I got it. There we go. Armature state. Here we go. For armature state. Do I have anything particularly fancy? Not really. Okay. I'll just kind of put the pool here. So class. I'm just going to call it that. So it's public. Component pool base. And it's also a faux data pool fo entity ID, with the component being an fo armature state. Close it up like that. Let's public that. Data pool include fo imx from pool base. Okay, we've got that. State pools. Got a new one. We're gonna call it armature state. I need armature dot maintenance. Simulation set, I'll need to add it. So let's call it armature. It's like faux armature or faux armature state. Like armature is definitely different from the state of the armature, really. Realistically, okay, we'll do armature state. Armature state pool, yes. Got that there. Now, I need to figure out where I use armature states. It's mostly for position. Is it position descriptor pool? No, it'd be animation processing. Yeah, there we are. Actually, it's kind of true. Let me double check that the animation is actually working right now, which means I need to go into here, the data A, the render mesh. I need to get rid of the rigid body, so I just call it rigid body disable. Just check that. Check it out. Check it out. Come on. The CPU is pretty hot. I'm not doing that much. Okay, the animation is still going strong. Good. So roll back on to this. We're going to change up animation processing. We're going to do a second one, which will, instead of this, it'll take in the data pool. What is this? The armature pool. This is the resource pool. Yeah. It's like that. This is going to be the second one. It's going to have this. How would this work? This is currently just using the first armature, regardless. Right. Or no, it's using a real one. Okay. Okay, we're just going through the armature states like that. Okay, so for auto star p data equals no, we're going to do it this way. State pool. What is it, data? I forget which one it was. Is it like get? Begin. Type one, like that. You know what? Yeah. Beginning to end, incrementing it like that. We got that P armature state. So it's get out of here. Okay. Nope, I'm still going through. Right. Well, what? Of course, I get the wrong one. Just the one I wanted to do right here. Okay. So. Process our mature states. We do the same thing here, but for the second one. So it's not that, it's P state, armature state. Second processing. I thought I did. Armature states too. Maybe it's just a bit of an issue elsewhere. Where else do we use this? We'll probably use it where we're creating the position data. So, We do the arbitrary state for the map. Nothing's gonna blow apart right now, right? Still good? We're still good. Okay. Animation's still going. Okay. Now. Let's close that one up, shall we? That one, that one, that one, that one. State pools. What I'm looking for is arbitrary states. We use this somewhere here. What's going on? Okay, that's going through that. Okay. That's not a great thing to do. Okay. Okay, we got that, we got that, we got that. So now it goes down to this. The uploading of the bone offsets. Woo! Go to the declaration. We're going to have to change this right here. So this is the resource pool. So here we go. We got the faux armature state pool. Oh, pool. There we are. We're going into the other side, so let's just go to. Okay, this is where it happens. Find. We'll find the iterator first. Because that's the entity ID. If it's the end. Or size. Then it becomes p armature state equals armature state pool begin 1 plus search iterator. Call it that instead. I don't like this searching, finding, retrieval mechanism. It's just not quite right. Still, let's see how this works. Or rather, doesn't. No declaration matches. Is that because it's const? Yeah. Ah, this is worse. This is much worse. Nothing's happening now. Wonderful. Close that up. Close that up. Animation, here we are. So what's going on here is render states. And there's only two of these, so search offset is 0. Okay. I don't like it. Realistically, if it reaches this point, it should be real. So why am I not finding it then? We know this one's real. It's in this other one, which I can't quite. It's 1 of 3. Okay. So I'm going to look at first that 3. Search offset 0. Why? P-armature state pool has what? Nothing stored. Nothing to insert. whatsoever. Oh my God, that. So it's 2 o'clock in the morning, and which is causing me to apparently not realize the fact that I'm not even importing the data in the first place. Like, come on. Okay. So let's see if we can get a entity CPP onto the side. Shrink that a little bit. Okay. Moving up. Moving on up. Armature state. Sorry. That one. No, this is local. So this one needs a group translator. It's not for, it's foe. Down here. Okay, we can do both. Go back to VK animation. Please. Please. Okay. We've got real stuff. This has real stuff, right? Yes, it does. It is found. Oh, praise be. Praise be, praise be. And there it is, using the new set. So, get rid of the old armature state. Not quite. Oh, because I was con My bad, my bad, my bad, my bad. It was just not finding it and continuing straight back out before got to the new stuff. There we are, there we are, there we are. That means now we can get rid of the old armature map from here. From here. That also means we don't really need this here. Just need the for declaration. That should be enough. Whoops, state pools. Arbiter states goes away. That is no longer applicable here. You're absolutely right. That needs to be changed. But that's export, not really going to care about it right now. Or actually, oh no, I can actually totally care about it. It's very easy to change. Done deal. Oh, whoa. Perfect. Just like on mobile, as soon as you click something, pop up shows up and redirects you somewhere else. Animation processing. So this becomes the only one here. Well, only one. There can be only one. Oh, get out of the way, out of the way, out of the way. There we go. Okay. You go just a little bit required. Armature pool, armature state, armature pool. I gotta be real careful. I'm redlining on RAM here. 7.5 gigs. Yikes. Oh, something went wrong. VK animation. Yes, the old stuff. Or no. Okay. So one thing, that's that. So I can actually reset that, turn your body back on, and work on render state. The last map. So let's check out render state. Render state. There you are. No, not using class. Oh, render state pool. Whoops, diddly doodly, there we go. Fixed up. Okay. Okay, what I need to do is find locations of this, which I think is basically only when I'm doing animation processing, really? And then I'm passing the data through around like that, I guess. Okay. Okay. Oh, I actually do need to have Okay. That's this one. It leaves us with the requirement to, well, first of all, NP simulation set state dot render state. Then otherwise, I have to get this. does this return? Yeah, this else return false. I haven't done anything there, and I think I need to do the same thing here. So up we go. A la copy and a la paste. Right about to here. Okay. Wonderful. Looking for this specifically. Wonderful, it died a terrible early death. No, it died here, didn't it? What? It's being deinitialized while we're still doing stuff elsewhere. Okay. It's because it's hitting here, isn't it? Render triangle. Okay, hold on, I gotta deal with a cat that's blocking my monitor. Out of the way. Okay, where was I? Yes. Why is there only one thing here? Render state. Now, right now, state, there's two render states, right? There's two. I haven't got the importer yet. Silly, silly me. Again. Doing the same old mistake. There we go. Okay, let's add it. Okay. Let's try this again. Okay. Okay. We'll just go to skip draw instead. These. Actually, this entire function is now gone. Goodbye. State pools, translator is no longer required. The old map. Maintenance, correct. Get to that way, yes. We got a problem somewhere, such as right here, render states. Yep, that goes away. Oh, yes. Wait, that's extraordinarily fast. If I recall correctly, it used to be 2 milliseconds. Now it's like hovering around one or under. That's improved on this computer. Somehow. I'll take that as a win. There's changes for those. That should also mean something along the line of, do I actually need these things? I need these things. I don't need map. I don't need memory either. Don't need this, and I don't need this. What do I need? Do I need map? Not here. Do I need render state? Nope, not here. These I do, I think. No, I do not. They'll be included for other things, sure. Array I do. I'm betting I'm just missing something out of here. So the render state pool, I need to include that. What about simulation set? Anything I can do? I got the vectors, those are required. Render state. Not really much I can do about that. Okay, make a test. Make format. Okay. Dynamic pools. The allowing for relocations. Okay. Put that up and we'll call it a night at that. That's some progress. Cheers.